Getting started with ATS 430. Hello. Today, we will guide you through the installation, wiring, and commissioning of your ATS 430. ATS 430 can start and stop motors used in applications such as compressors, conveyors, pumps, fans, agitators, and mixers. Unpacking. Unpack your ATS 430 and verify that it has not been damaged. Scan the QR code in front of the soft starter to get your product data sheet and the technical documentation in digital format. Verify that the mains voltage value is compatible with the product. Mounting. Install the ATS 430 inside a cabinet. The product has to be mounted vertically as shown in the printed Getting Started. To have more information about the mounting conditions, please refer to the ATS 430 user manual. After mounting, wire the ATS 430. In our example, we will follow the diagram given in the printed Getting Started. The system must be protected against short circuit and the motor against overload. Q1, circuit breaker, provides the short circuit protection. The motor overload protection is provided by the soft starter. KM1, line contactor. T1, transformer, used to adapt or reduce the power voltage to the recommended control voltage. A1, A2. Q2, fast-acting fuses, protection of the soft starter, to be used only when type 2 coordination, according to IEC 60947-42, is required. Q3, circuit breaker, protection for the primary of the transformer. Q4, circuit breaker, protection for the secondary of the transformer. Q5, circuit breaker, protection for the control part of the soft starter. Wiring. ATS 430 supports 2-wire or 3-wire control. Start by wiring the ground cable and the motor cables. Then, wire the mains. Remove the red sticker. Wire the ATS 430 control supply. The A1 and A2 terminals must be supplied within 110 to 230 volts AC. To access the control terminals, open the cover. Wire the control terminals according to the run and stop management. The relays of the ATS 430 admit a maximum voltage of 230 volts AC. Commissioning. In our example, we will configure the ATS 430 to run a conveyor using a squirrel cage induction motor class 10 thermal protection. Power on your soft starter by switching on Q5, then Q4, then Q3, then Q1. The soft starter is powered on and mains is supplied. At first power on, you must go through the initial setup procedure. You must set the language, time zone, date, and local time. Press OK for 2 seconds to confirm the settings. Set the cybersecurity policy. In this example, we select Minimum CyberSec to set no credentials and access the main menu. If you want to set credentials, select Advanced CyberSec or download an existing configuration. For more information about cybersecurity, refer to the ATS 430 user manual on se.com. Now we set access level. It will change the parameter visibility. Here we select standard. Once it's done, go to Simply Start menu. set motor nominal current according to your motor nameplate. Determines the current of the motor thermal monitoring depending on which motor class is set. Set the following parameters according to your needs. Limiting current. Set the maximum current authorized by the soft starter during the ramp-up phase according to your application. It is a percentage of motor nom current. Acceleration. This is the time for the soft starter to start from zero torque to reach nominal torque. Initial starting torque. It is the initial torque setting during the starting phases. It varies from 0 to 100% of the nominal torque. If set too low, the motor may not start as soon as the run command is applied. We set type of stop to deceleration. Soft stopping by control of the torque is well adapted for this kind of application. By default, torque control is active. Refer to the user manual for more information on torque and voltage control. We can now set deceleration to set the time to decelerate from the estimated torque to standstill. Then, set end of deceleration to set the final torque level between 0 and 100% of the estimated torque at the end of deceleration. As soon as the estimated torque is below the value sets in end of deceleration, the motor switches to freewheel mode. You can now start your motor. Refer to run and stop management in the user manual. To power up the power section, push S3. As we are in three-wire control, we apply a run command by pushing S5. The motor starts. We apply a stop command by pushing S4. The motor stops according to type of stop. To remove supply from the power section, push S2. Status LEDs and troubleshooting. At any time, LEDs can be checked in order to know the status of the soft starter. For more information, refer to the user manual. In case of troubleshooting, scan the QR code in front of the soft starter to get warning and error codes explanations in the diagnostics section. For example, if you have an overcurrent error, by clicking on the corresponding error, you can get the probable cause and how to fix it. For more information, download the ATS430 user manual on se.com. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.